This here, in this video, what we are going to say is about the asymptotic notation. So what is asymptotic notation? An algorithm efficiency can be represented by asymptotic notations. So for example, if we buy vegetables, then we buy in terms of kgs, kilograms and grams. When we buy oils or water, we bought it in terms of liters, ml, etc. Likewise, there are some units for measuring all the other things. Likewise, how you can measure the efficiency of the algorithm through mathematically. So mathematical notation, that is where comes the asymptotic notation. So representing the efficiency of an algorithm in terms of mathematical notation, we call it as an asymptotic notation. So here, there are three types of asymptotic notation broadly. They are theta notation, omega notation, and Big O notation. We'll see what it is. Theta notation. Here, if you imagine this is the function execution, there will be a lower bound and the upper bound of the time. The time of execution of the function. So definitely in theta notation, the function will execute between the lower bound and upper bound. So the time will be only between these two. So this is said to be average case. So here for a function g of n, theta g of n is given by the relation like this. There exists a positive constant c1 and c2. Here c1 and c2. In such a way that, and n0 is nothing but the number of executions, so on. Such that here, if you say function is, this is 0, function is greater than c1 g of n, which is greater than 0, and here it is less than c2 gn for all n greater than or equal to n0. So here, what you mean by this actually is nothing but, the function execution will be between a lower bound and upper bound. That's what actually here it means. So there will be an average. And we call this, if the function, if the time execution is between these lower and upper bound, we call it as an average case. Big O notation. This is nothing but specification of only upper bound. There will be no lower bound. That means, the program will execute till the upper bound. That we call it as a worst case. If you take unsorted array and you are going to search an element, then definitely the searching, if the element is somewhere, say for example 100th place, if the element number of elements is 100 and the search element is at the 100th element, then you have to search in a linear search, or if it is an unsorted array also, you have to go through the whole of the array, which means the end of the array. So that is what by mean of upper bound. Okay, so that is said to be the upper bound, and this is said to be a worst case. Omega notation. Here it is lower bound. At any time, within a short period of time, the program will execute, and this will be considered as the best case. So for example, if you take binary search algorithm, the search algorithm will be divided logarithmic search. Logarithmic complexity it has. Each time it will be the search space is divided by 2 and so on, and it will narrow down the search space. So in this case, we call it within a few searches, it will find the value which we are searching. So that we can call it as a best case, and it will be always lower. It will be a lower bound. So this we call it as a lower bound. For example, given this small coding, we'll see what is the time complexity and space complexity, and we try to express in terms of Big O method, which is nothing but the worst case. So if you take this, A equal to 0, B equal to 0, since these are all very small, we don't consider this, but we will consider the, first let us consider the time. Here there are four options are there, which is the correct answer. If you say this loop will be executing definitely up to N. So after this loop is over, this loop exits, which is m. So definitely n plus m will come. So whether this or this is the dilemma. So what happened next, we will be seeing these two are correct for time complexity, but here the question is space complexity also. So now if you go through, it is not n plus n, it is order of one, because when you take you will be, this will be very negligibly small, the space occupied by this is very small. So what we do is, it will occupy only the space occupied, there is no additional space being utilized. So we can write the space complexity to be order of 1. So this is the correct answer. Another example we will see with this fragment of code. Here, if you see this thing, running time, that is time complexity. So n into n, clearly this shows there are loop within loop. So n number of n into n number of times, this will be, this code will be executed. So definitely it will be n square. The complexity is n square. Then given this code, what will happen? For loop executes first and then again j loop. So these two are separate. So you can say order of n will be the big O of this. At any time, any point of time, it will execute n number of times. Then given the following code fragment, what will be the big O? Here, if you see that I, it is a while loop, and here I is divided by 2. So first term, if I is equal to 10, 10 is greater than 0, so it goes inside. Now I by 2, it becomes 5. So drastically it reduces, not 10. 10 has become now 5. Then when it go inside again 5, 5 by 2, it becomes 2 and so on. The next time it comes out of the loop. So within 3, the loop, it will come out. Not the whole up to 10 elements. So here if you see that, the search will be reduced, and so it is a logarithmic search, logarithmic complexity. O log n can be represented as O log n. Now let us consider this for a calculation of variable space. So if you say this namespace, so you will leave all these things, but you can say sum of 0 and it calculates the it add the value from I 1 0 to 5 and print the value. Now if you take this, it occupies one execution, and this is 5 times 5 plus 1, because after 5 4 it becomes 5, and then here it comes, in checking only it will come out. So we can consider that also 1, so it's 6. So the for loop will be executed for, anyway the I will be incremented, and here it checks. So this check will take place. So we consider this as a 6 times this loop will be executed. But this will be executed only for 5 times, this instruction. Because it will not go inside. When it becomes 5, it automatically it comes out. So this will not be executed. So 5 times this sum equal to sum plus I will be done. And then this will be for one time, and this will be for one time. So when you calculate the time complexity, you have to add all these things. So 1 plus 6 plus 5 plus 1 plus 1. Here 6 you can consider as n plus 1. You can represent it in terms of n plus 1. And this 5, n times. So when you represent, reduce it, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this 4, n plus n, 2n. So considering how to find out the big O notation, discard the leading constants. So we leave this. And then ignore the lower order terms. We leave this also. So finally we get order of n. So this can be represented as the order of n will be the time complexity of this program. Then another program, search. When we are going to search in this array, we are going to see all the case, best case, worst case, as well as the average case. Suppose this is a element. Here we pass an array and then the value to be searched. Imagine we are going to, what is the best case? Well, if the array we give it has a 30 as the first value. Suppose imagine 10 is the first value to be searched. Here we pass the value 10. Immediately we find the answer. So what happens if a of I, a of 0 equal to 10, return 1. So this will return to the main program, the calling program, where it found the value. So at the first value search itself, it would have, that will be the best case. So which can be represented as theta of 1. What may be the worst case? If the value 10 is not at all present in this. So for example, 110. We are going to search the value 110 in this. So what happened? It go through whole of the array and it will return as 0. So for I equal to 0 to the whole array will be searched for the missing value, which is not present. So in this case, the worst case will be big O n. What will be the average case? Suppose the value now we are searching is 30 and it is here. After the third search itself, it may be present, or if the value to be searched is 50, within the five search we will can find. And if you are going to apply a binary search, fastly we will be able to find. So that we can call it as an here average search, which will be represented as a here this is omega and this is a theta n. Another example, say there are three variables declared and a loop within loop. So n into n, this will execute for n number, n square, and three elements are there, three statements are there. Here another for loop and one variable. So if you calculate this, first it is 3, so we have n at time complexity for execution of this 3, and then for this it is n square. Three statements are there, so the 3 into the 3 times 3 into n square times this will be executed, and the next one two statements are there and they execute for n times, so 2n here plus 1. Only this small snippets we consider. So when you add this thing, we can represent it as 3n square 2n plus 4. So now it is a quadratic n square. So this is a quadratic time complexity. So best case, worst case and average case. Worst case complexity algorithm is a function defined by the maximum number of steps taken on any instant of size n. It is the slowest time taken to complete with a given input. Best case is fastest time taken to complete with the optimal inputs. Whereas the average case is a function defined by the average number of steps taken on any instance of size n. This is nothing but arithmetic mean. Now if you consider the big O notation, rate of growth of the given the input, how the execution time varies, it can be represented, it is given in this table. If n is equal to 5, then log n within 3 search, or within that 3 execution you can get the answer, whereas just n means it takes up to this. So all these are big O notation, big O. So here n log n means this much time it will take, that given the value 5 it will take this much time for execution, whereas n squared it is in quadratic and n cube is cubic and 2 power n is exponentiation. If you see that, see 100 and so on. Now if you see the various representation of asymptotic notations, here 1 means the constant, it will be given here, log n it will be slight. So this time, this way it is a representation of time, and this representation of the number of values, number of n. So when you say linear, when you give the n, it accordingly the value will be there. So when given the value n, based on the value of n, the execution time may increase or decrease. So it is said to be linear. So depending upon this time and the input, the value constantly increases. This is log linear, and then here n into log n, n squared, quadratic. You can see massive increase in time. If it is a quadratic, the time taken by that particular loop will take more time. Likewise, cubic and exponentiation. Even for a smaller n values, it will be, the execution time will be more. So that's what here represents. Whereas all these things, even if the number of value is more, it constantly only very small, within a short time period, it will be executed. That is what this picture represents.